Guys, my name is Mandeep, and in today's video we are going to discuss about linked list insertion. Inserting a node in linked list is always a tricky and important topic. So let's get started. First we will cover it with the example, then we'll try to write down an ELCO code based on that example that we are going to discuss about. So now let us assume that this is our linked list. Possibly we are taking a short linked list of only of three nodes, and this is my first node which is with the head pointer, and this is my last node which is ultimately pointing to the null, and this has, let us say, some integer data, right? So insertion in linked list can happen at three places. One is at the beginning. And the second one is, if we talk about at last, and third one we are going to talk about at particular position. Fine. So first we are going to discuss about at the beginning. Now let us assume that this is our linked list, and if we have to insert a node, now assume that this is a node with integer data as a 4, and we have to insert this node in this linked list. So how it is going to happen in memory or in process? So this happens, let us assume this is our linked list and this is the node to be inserted. So whenever we have to insert at the beginning, how it is going to happen? There will be two operations. First operation will be the next pointer of this new node will point to the this node, which is first being pointed out by head pointer. And next, in the second step, now this is our first step, and now in second step, how it will be? Now this is head, this is my head pointer. In second step, head pointer is being updated. Now it will point to the this new node which is which has been inserted, which is now pointing to the previous head node. So there are two operations. One is new pointer of next pointer of this new node will point to the node which was head node earlier, and in second operation this head pointer will being updated, and this head pointer will point to this newly now added node. At last, how it will happen? Again, two operations will be done when we have to insert a node at the last. So how it will be like when we have to insert a node at last? Now assuming the same example, this is the node to be inserted, and this is our linked list, earlier linked list, and which is now this is my last node, and it is pointing to the null. So in first operation, next pointer of this node will point to the null, because this ultimately this node will become the last node because we are inserting at the last. And in the second operation, the next pointer of earlier last node which was earlier pointing to the null will point to the this newly added node. Then how it will be like? This is 5 3 2, and before this, as in after first operation, now this 4 is pointing to null, and instead of next pointer of this node will point to the null, it will be updated to the newly node, and then next pointer of newly added node will always point to the null because it is the last node. And at a particular position, now if I say this is a node linked list of 3 nodes, and if we have to add a particular node at the, say at position 2, then how this operation will take place? Let us assume the same. So in this case, it will be kind of 3 operations in this process. First we need to identify, let us say if we have to add node at the second position, then we have to traverse in that linked list till the position where we want to add. Now this is my first position, this is my second position, and this is my third position, and we want to add a new node at this second position. So we have to traverse till the previous node where we want to add, and then the pointer updation will happen. So at a particular, now in this example I am taking as I have to add a node at second position. Now at second position, to add a node at second position, first I need to traverse till second position. I will stay a node before where we want to add. We want to add at the second position, so we will stay at the index first, this one, and after coming here, and let now again assume that we are going to add this new node, how pointer operations will happen? Always the new node which we have to insert, first we have to link that node with the linked list. So the next pointer of this node will point to the this next node where we want to add a particular position. So after this operation, how it will be? It will be like this. And 4 is also pointing to this node. And after this operation, we have to update the next pointer of the previous node to the newly added node. So after this operation will be, now if I assume this is the newly node added, it will point to here, and this operation has already been done in the first part, and so to add a particular position, first we need to traverse till that position. We stop at one index before that position, then we point, then we the next pointer of the newly node will point to the index of that position where we want to add that one, and in the third operation the next pointer of the previous node will point to the newly added node. So this are the 3 different cases: at the beginning, at the last, and at a particular position. So for the same, if we have to write a pseudocode or algorithm, how it may look like, this is only the visualization part, how things happen in back of the stage. Now we are going to write some algo part. So let me quickly clean this and I'll write the algo part. So in the same algo we are going to cover all these cases. So very first, now let us assume that list node is a class which I have already created in my previous lecture. List node is nothing, is representing this node, and now I am taking this as a list node. Insert in linked list. Now there will be 3 parameters. One will be the head node, the second one will be the node to be inserted, which will be of, again will be of type list node or node, whatever you want to take this. Since again this is a algo, so you can write whatever you like, how you want to represent it. Now assume that node to insert, and the third one is the int position. I am taking as third parameter. This int position will be the position where we want to add a particular node. So if very first case becomes if head is null, head pointer is null, then that means there is no node in the linked list, then simply return newly node which we want to insert. So node to insert. Now if next case becomes if the position is less than 1 or greater than length of list, length of linked list is greater than this plus 1. That means position can never be less than 1. That means if you will pass that add this new node at a 0 position, so there is no index, so it is going one of the another edge cases. And if you are going to say that my length, now this is the method I already have, this implementation I already have discussed in my previous video. Some of the key terms I am taking my previous video, you can refer from there. So length is giving me the length of this linked list in which I am just passing the head node, and if the length is greater than plus 1, that means if my length is 3 and I am saying that add a node greater than at 3 plus 1, I say if I add 5, so there will be no pointer, because length is 3, you can maximally add at the index 4. So in this case it will simply ask system.out.println, it will give you error, please enter a valid position. So this is one of the corner cases. Now if we have to add a node at the beginning, then in that case what does it mean? It means that we are saying that add the position 1, to add a position 1 there will be two pointer updation operation. First the newly node will point to the head node, and the head that head pointer will be updated with the newly added node. So how it is going to happen? If position is 1, then this is the node to insert which we want to add, node to insert dot set next is again can be referred my from previous video, is now, which is now current head node, and return node to insert. It will simply return that. So there are two operations. This is the beginning, and to handle the other cases like adding a node at the end or at a particular position, how it is going to be? It is going to be in else case. Now as I already told you, to add at a particular position we need to traverse till that position before that one index behind. So how it is going to happen? Now let us assume that I will take as a temp variable list node, which is of my, I will say it as a previous node, is and I start with the head. Now while say position, I am taking one more point, int count is equal to 0. While count is less than position, then what we need to do, we need to just traverse till the previous node. Then how it is going to happen, previous node is equal to previous node dot set next, sorry, get next. So it will give me the next node and simply keep increasing counter. So it will, this we will come out of this while loop just before the one index behind where we want to add. So after coming out of that, then we are taking one more variable, list node, say a current node where we want to add, and we will say previous dot get next. Now previous dot get next will give me the current node where we want to add. So this is my current node, and now the pointer operations will happen. How they will happen? Very first node to insert dot set next, will be current, and previous node dot set next will be my node to insert, and then in last return my head node. It's very simple. This seems to be quite complex. I am going to iterating once again. Very simple. First, take start with the head node and just assign it to a previous in a variable, say previous, and keep iterating through the linked list till the position where we want to add it. So in this case, if we want to add at the second position, we will stop at the first position. So once we will come out of this loop, we will be at here. Then what we are going to do, so this in this example, and if I try to link this algo, now previous dot get next, now this is my previous and we want to add at the second position, fine. So my previous dot get next is my current, this is my current, fine. What this will do, this will do node to insert dot set next. This node to insert is the new node set. Now the next pointer of node new, this node will point to the this current node. This line will do this, newly node will now point to this node, and after that this was my previous node. Previous node dot set next will point to the this new node dot node to insert, and I am just returning that head node. So this is how insertion in linked list can happen. Maybe this has got some messy kind of thing, but I think this will help you out in if you will visualize and try to link the code with the example. So that's all for today. Thank you.